Find the coordinates of foci, vertices, the length of major axis, the minor axis, the eccentricity and the latus rectum of the ellipse, x squared by 25 plus y squared by 9 equal to 1. Okay, find the coordinates of foci, vertices, the length of major axis and minor axis, the eccentricity and the latus rectum of the foci. The given ellipse is x squared divided by 25 plus y squared divided by 9 equal to 1. Okay. So the given equation of ellipse is x squared by 25 plus y squared by 9 equal to 1. Let it be equation number 1. Okay. So by observing the given equation, we can understand denominator of x squared by 25 is larger. Okay. The denominator of x squared, which is 25, and the denominator of y squared is 9. Okay, so 25 greater than 9. So we can say denominator of x squared by 25 is larger than the denominator of y squared by 9. Okay, which means major axis is along x axis. Suppose if the equation is x squared by 9 plus y squared by 25 equal to 1. Such kind of equations having the denominator of x squared is less than that of the denominator of y squared, then the major axis belongs to y axis. Okay. Here the denominator of x squared is 9. And the denominator of y squared, here the denominator is 9, here the denominator is 25. Okay, here the denominator of y squared by 25 is greater. Okay, then the denominator of x squared by 9. Okay, so such kind of equations have the major axis as y axis, but in the given equation, denominator of x squared is greater than that of the denominator of y squared. Okay, so denominator of x squared by 25 is larger than the denominator of y squared by 9. So major axis is x axis. Okay, major axis is along x axis. So compare with x squared by a squared plus y squared by b squared equal to 1. Now comparing the given equation with the standard equation, we get here a squared, instead of a squared we have 25. Okay, now compare with the x squared by a squared plus y squared by b squared equal to 1. This is the standard equation now of ellipse with the major axis x axis. Okay, a squared is equal to 25 and b squared equal to 3. Okay, if we compare, we can get a squared equal to 25, b squared equal to 9. So by on comparison, we get a squared equal to 25. If a squared equal to 25, then a equal to plus or minus square root of 25. Square root of 25 will be equal to 5. Okay, so a squared is equal to 25, so a is equal to plus or minus 5. B squared equal to 9, so b is equal to plus or minus root 9, which is equal to plus or minus 3. Okay, so the next step is c squared. We know that the relation between a, b, c for ellipse is c squared is equal to a squared minus b squared. So c squared is equal to, substitute the value of a squared and b squared in this equation, c squared is equal to 25 minus 9. Okay, the value of a squared is 25, the value of b squared is 9. So c squared is equal to 25 minus 9. C squared equal to 25 minus 9. So c squared is equal to 25 minus 9 is 16. Okay, so c squared is equal to 16. So c squared is equal to 16. So c is equal to plus or minus square root of 16. Okay, c is equal to plus or minus square root of 16 is 4. Okay, so C is equal to plus or minus 4. Okay, so first you have to determine the which denominator is greater. Here x squared is greater, the denominator of x squared is greater than that of the denominator of y squared. So we can determine that, so we can conclude that the given ellipse has major axis as x axis. Okay, suppose the denominator of y squared is greater than that of the denominator of x squared, the major axis becomes y axis. Okay, so coordinates of foci f of plus or minus c comma 0, so already we have calculated c is equal to plus or minus 4. The denominator of coordinates of foci, the formula is f of plus or minus c comma 0, so value of c is 4, so which is equal to f of plus or minus 4 comma 0. Okay, then the coordinates of vertices v of plus or minus a comma 0, we know that we already have found a is equal to plus or minus 5. So coordinates of vertices v of plus or minus a comma 0, so plus or minus 5 comma 0. Length of major axis is, the formula for length of major axis is 2a. The length of major axis is 2a. The value of a is 5. So 2 into 5, so which is equal to 10 units. Okay. The length of minor axis, the formula is 2b. The value of b is 3. Okay. B squared is 9, so b is 3. So 2 into b, which is equal to 2 into 3, that is equal to 6 units. Okay. Eccentricity, e is equal to, the definition for eccentricity, e is equal to c by a. The value of c is 4 and a is 5. Okay. So e is equal to 4 by 5. Okay. The eccentricity we have calculated, which is equal to 4 by 5. The length of the lattice rectum, 2b squared by a. So that is equal to 2 into the value of b. B squared is 9. Okay. The value of b is 3. So 2 into 3 squared divided by 5, which is equal to 2 into 9 divided by 5. So that is equal to 2 into 9 will be equal to 18 divided by 5. Okay.